these prayers, the Shanti Mantras and other prayers also, the first day I said that they are actually prayers suggested to our own self. It is not praying to somebody sitting somewhere in the sky. When we pray like that, if we are praying with proper sincerity, it's not just a word, then the Ichha Shakti in us, the consciousness, the sentient being in us, he is no other than the Brahman or the ultimate truth from where the whole universe has emerged, has come. So when we pray, we can say that we are praying to God or we are praying to some natural powers, whatever we may say, it is finally praying to our own self, the Ichha Shakti in us which is there. So if we are sincere in our prayer, then right then will be the result. When we pray that may we be pure, if we are sincere in our prayer, then purity will come immediately. Depending on the sincerity, the amount of purity also will come. Because the purity has to come to all over our being, it may take time to become purer and purer. But depending on our sincerity, the intensity, the longing for purity in us, it will definitely come. So the prayers are not at all to be neglected. They are the only thing which works. They are self-suggesting. When we say that Saha Viryam Karavavahai, that whatever we do, let us do with Virya, with courage. And the Upanishad tells us, where lies the courage? Atmana Vindate Viryam. The real courage lies within us, in our Atma. That means we are referring to ourselves as I. There itself lies the Virya. That means, when will we have that courage in doing everything? When we are harmonious with our own self. When we are looking to ourself, the real self, which we said is universal, which is beyond all constriction, transcending all constrictions. When we are associated with that self, when we are listening to that self, when we are harmonious with that self, then we will automatically get the strength. This is an experience for all of us. Whenever we do something deceiving ourselves, we find that we feel weak about it. Nobody has to tell us. It is for us to judge. Whenever we are betraying our inner voice, everybody has that inner voice. It is only a difference in listening to it. Because of we are too much overwhelmed with our desires, with our constricted ideas, with our constricted desires, that we try not to listen to that voice. Otherwise the voice is always there, because it is our own voice, it is our Atma, it is the voice of the God, whatever we may say. The voice of Brahman, the voice of Truth, the voice of God is our own voice, that we should understand. And if we look within, that voice is always there. And there lies the courage. That is how, from that Atma, when we derive the courage and do something, then even if the whole world goes against us, we don't mind. Let it go. We may have to die, then also we don't mind. That is how, even in freedom fighting and other cases also, people take to such dire consequence without any difficulty. They get their strength from the Atma. And if we go into the history, we will find that all of the freedom fighters, the most of the greatest freedom fighters, they got their strength from their spiritual being. So, Saha Viryam Karavavahai, whatever we do, we must do with, in harmony with the Atma, with our inner voice. That is what the Shanti Mantra is saying. When we say that, it is reminding ourselves that we should do it like that. It is reminding ourselves, it is not that we are praying to God or Brahman, that may we do like this. Then the prayer will remain just words. It will not have any result. While praying, our prayer should become sincere. that we must want it, we must aspire for it, then it will definitely happen.